Hey folks, James Lee here for another episode of Azure This Week, where we bring you the latest and greatest of all things Azure. And today, I've got three updates that can help you go on to develop secure solutions in Azure. We'll take a look at the public preview of Microsoft DevBox, general availability of dedicated host support for Azure Kubernetes Service, and general availability of NSG support for private endpoints. Step one for developing solutions in Azure is to have a machine with everything you need. If you're building a web app, maybe you need a PC with Visual Studio and perhaps a point-to-site VPN connection into your Azure virtual network. Or perhaps you're developing games and maybe you need something entirely different. And what about if you are working remotely? Well, to help ensure that developers can focus on writing code instead of having to burn through all of that time setting up their development machines, Microsoft has introduced Microsoft DevBox. It's kind of like a developer PC as a service. This product allows you to provide self-service, on-demand access to Windows-based development machines. Now, these machines can be pre-configured to include all of the tools, connectivity, and security that you require for different development projects across your organization. Now, having standardized development environments available on demand can not only help to minimize administration effort and costs, but it can also help to provide consistent security. Keen to start your cloud journey? We've just launched a new limited time offer for our personal annual plan, saving you 40%. These plans give you access to great course features like hands-on labs and practice exams, making it easier to kickstart your cloud career. If you're interested, then scan the QR code on the screen or click the link in the description below. But be quick, you've only got until the end of Friday to take up this offer. If you're developing containerized solutions in Azure, you may have heard of Azure Kubernetes Service, also known as AKS for short. But what if you're developing a highly secret containerized solution? Maybe you love the idea of AKS and how easily you can get Kubernetes in the cloud with native Azure integration, but maybe you're not actually allowed to host your top secret containerized solution on infrastructure that other customers share with you. Well, I'm sure you can see where I'm going with this story. With AKS now supporting dedicated hosts, you can now host your AKS containers on hypervisors that are dedicated just to you. Dedicated hosts have been around for a while now, allowing customers to run virtual machines and virtual machine scale sets on physical hypervisors that are dedicated to a single customer only. And with this update, you can now leverage this secure technology for AKS as well. Azure has a range of services that are built for public global access, and that can be great. But let's say you've developed an app hosted on a virtual machine and it uses blob storage to house your highly confidential data. Now in this scenario, public accessibility not so good. You don't want to end up on the front page of the news as a security breach story. Instead, you would want to use something like private endpoints to disable that public accessibility, but still allow access to your storage account only from resources within a virtual network. Now, we have been able to do this for a while by using private endpoints. And whilst there's support for a lot of different services for private endpoints, there wasn't support for network security groups to help restrict this private access further within the virtual network itself. Well, with the release of network security group support for private endpoints, you can now configure network security group rules to control access to your private endpoints within your virtual networks. So if you want to allow only private access, you can still do that. But if you want to take it one step further and restrict private access, maybe to just a single virtual machine in your virtual network, you can now do that too. Well, that's a wrap for today, everyone. For more awesome updates on all things Azure, be sure to tune in again to next week's episode. Until then, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.